Hey Osong, welcome to your fourth lesson with me, Gabby teacher. If you notice the light's a little different, it's because we are in my house today. I am home from school this week, as are all the rest of you teachers, I believe. So yay, we get to be in my house. I'm gonna start with going over the survey from last week that you guys took. I heard there was a little bit of confusion, and I want to clear that up. Welcome to class. Yay. So our goals for today, we will review last week's survey, have a new dialogue, 1.1, 2.1 and 2.2, not 1.1. Parents Day, slang time, assignment, song of the day. All right, let's go. So last week I asked you, how did you celebrate Children's Day? And some of you had some good responses. I watched a movie at home. I visited Hwanggwidanggil in Gyeongju. Very cool. I enjoyed eating delicious foods. I ate outside with my family and looked around Seoul. Hopefully it wasn't too scary there. I played with my friend and I went camping. All of these are very good grammatically correct answers. There were a lot of other good answers too. If yours wasn't perfect, don't worry. I still read it and I enjoyed reading all of your responses. I almost forgot. I visited my grandma's house. Also a very good answer. Okay, now we get to the slang part, which confused a lot of you guys, and I want to clarify that right now. So the question was, use the slang woke in a sentence. And when I say slang woke, I mean use the new way I showed you how to use woke in a sentence, and not using woke like I woke up in the normal way. So for example, this is what the PowerPoint looked like last week when I introduced this word woke. I first introduced the normal use, which is how most English speakers use the word woke. Woke is the past tense of wake. So I started out with this to give you guys something to base off the slang later when I introduce it. So this is the original way we use woke. When I give the surveys, I don't want the normal way, basically. I think that's what confused some of you guys. Do I do the normal way? Do I do the slang way? Please don't use the normal way. I already know that you know how to use the normal way, so I don't want this one. No. So a lot of you guys answered the normal way, and that's okay. They were all good answers. All grammatically correct, and yeah. Now the slang version is what I'm looking for. The slang means like hip or new way to say something. So this one, as you can see, the first woke is dongsa. It's a verb. The slang woke is hyeongyeongsa, and it describes a person or a feeling. In the surveys, I always want you to use the slang version. If I present you with two options, always use the slang one in the survey. Okay, and I had some really good answers for this, but first let's go over what I mean. Oh yeah, this is the one I'm looking for in the future. Slang. Okay. This was the example I gave you to learn about woke. I'm not very woke about global warming. I don't know very much about global warming, is what that means. Okay, so these are, these are some examples that I got from students. The challenge was to use the slang woke in a sentence. The first one was, I am woke at society issues. This was very close. I corrected it a little bit. I am woke about social issues, but you were very close. I'll count that as an answer. Oh, I'm so woke, also good. You must vote if you're woke. This was a really good one because it makes a lot of sense. When you vote for someone, it means that you are putting your faith in someone in power. So if you're voting, it probably means you know what's going on and what they're running for, like that. So this was a really good example. I wonder if you got it off the internet or from your own head, but if you got it from your own head, very good. Okay. I kind of corrected this one. I don't woke this slang. I think this person meant I don't know this slang, but you can use it with woke. And what you could say is, I am not woke about slang, meaning I don't really know much about English slang. But good effort with that. I am not woke about global pandemic. This was a great example because it applies to today, meaning I don't know much about the global pandemic. She isn't woke about air pollution. This was a good one. I am woke student because I am interested in social issues. Social issues. So these were all good examples about woke and being aware of what's going on in the world. For future reference, I will always color code the slang in orange, right there, and the normal version in blue. So don't use the blue one, use the orange one in surveys, okay? All right, let's move on to our next question, which was, third question. Can you make a sentence where I would respond with, why didn't you say so? So this was kind of tricky and confused a lot of students. Basically, all I wanted you to do was make a sentence. So you make the sentence, your letter A, and I would have to say, why didn't you say so? So your sentence had to make me respond with letter B. And I'll show you some examples. A lot of students had some good ideas. This one says, I didn't tell the teacher I was sick. So of course I would have to say, why didn't you say so? How come you didn't say anything earlier? This was a good example to start off with, I think. You had to be kind of creative and come up with your own idea. This one, I don't have materials. Today I forgot my pencil at home or something. I would say, oh, why didn't you say so? I have a pencil right here. Here you go. There's my pencil. Next one. Actually, I didn't go to the toilet. Well, why didn't you say so? Go now, is what I would say to that. Well, I don't know how to do it. Oh, why didn't you say so? I'll teach you how to do it. Well, you see, I was very sick last weekend. Oh, I'm sorry. Why didn't you say so? That was a good example. I liked it. I wanted to see a movie with you yesterday afternoon. Really? Why didn't you say so? I would have said yes. Good example. I think this is from the book, actually. This one I really liked. Yesterday was my birthday. Really? I saw you yesterday. How come you didn't say anything? Why didn't you say so? If it was your birthday, happy birthday. This was a great example. Because I couldn't imagine this being said in real life. Okay, so let's pretend you got in a fight with another student and a teacher comes, hey, what's going on here? And you're both in trouble, but then you say later, well, teacher, actually, they hit me first. I would say, really? Why didn't you say so? This was a good example. I could also imagine this being said like in a movie or in real life. So nice. I get this all the time from my students. When it's summertime, I always turn up the AC. Do I have my remote? I always turn up the AC to full blast because I am a warm person. So usually my students say, "Teacher, I'm a little bit cold right now," or something. And I'll say, "Oh, why didn't you say so? I will turn off the aircon so that you're not cold." Good answer. Okay, so I hope that clarified my expectations for you in the survey. If you have any other questions or any new questions about the next survey, please feel free to ask the teachers or me. And I will keep trying to provide clear instructions for you. This week's question in your survey is, if you could be any animal, what animal would you be and why? And you can respond with, I would be a blah, blah, blah. Or if you have your own way to start the sentence, that's fine. This is just an example for you to use. So my answer is, I would be a deer because I am kind of shy and I like to eat vegetables. So please answer this question in the survey. This is your mandatory question for the week. Okay, now let's learn the new dialogue in chapter 2. In chapter 2, we are learning how to offer something. To offer something means to ask someone if they want it. So an example, hey, would you like a grape? Or, this is an expression you probably already know. Do you want a grape? So these expressions kind of mean the same thing. They can be used interchangeably, but would you like a grape is a little bit more formal or polite than do you want. Maybe would you like, I would use with people older than me, people I just met. If I'm someone in a waitress, or if I'm someone in a restaurant, I would say, oh, would you like some water, instead of do you want some water, like this. So when we ask for something, we use this phrase. Can I have, now, what goes in the X? What do we say in the X part? We can say something like, can I have some? Can I have a? Can I have n? Like this. Remember, noun is 명사. Okay. So we're going to talk about the difference between some, a, and n today. Our example is, would you like some cake? Sure, I'll have some cake. Would you like an apple? Okay. And for A, would you like a glass of water? Yes, please. Like this. Okay, so what is the difference between, when do we use A or an? If it's one thing, we use A or an. Like one pen, we use A or an. Or a cookie, a glass, a piece of paper, like this. So we wouldn't say, would you like one peach? If we were offering something, we would say, would you like a peach? One peach isn't wrong, it's just a little awkward, I think. Nobody really says one peach. Unless you're trying to buy one peach, maybe. So that's the right way. We also wouldn't say, would you like one orange? We would instead say, would you like an orange? Now, why did I use N instead of A? I'll go over that in a second. Can you name all of the vowels in English first? Do you know the English vowels? They are A, E, I, O, and U. So these are important to know because we only use an with our vowels. So if the next word starts with a vowel, we use an. So for example, for the first A, would we use A or an? We would use A because sandwich starts with S. It's not a vowel. And egg, would you like an egg? Egg starts with E, which is a vowel. So we use an. It's that easy. When do we use some? So some is if it's more than one thing, or if you can't count it. Those are really the two situations we would use some. So for example, let's say I made 2 eggs today and I scrambled them up in my pan and I want to give you some eggs. We wouldn't say an egg because even though it's like a one serving of egg, it's you can't really count how much egg is inside that serving. So I would say, would you like some eggs? Like this. If it was like a hard-boiled egg, one egg, then I would say, would you like an egg? But this isn't really the same thing. If I'm offering soup, I could give you a bowl of soup, or I can give you some soup. So if I'm holding a bowl in my hands and I say, oh, would you like a bowl of soup? That's good. But if I don't say the bowl, I have to use some. So some here works. Okay. Here's a tip. You can also use verbs with a, an, and some. So for example, would you like to eat one soup? Don't use one here either. Would you like to eat some soup? Like this. So notice I have the verb in green and I just put it before some here. Like that. Okay. So let's practice with these these sentences. What goes here? Is it some, a, or an? Would you like water? The answer is some. Would you like some water? And it's because when I'm pouring the water, you can't really count how much water is coming out. So it's some water, like this. Okay. But if I have a water bottle, you could say a water, like this. Oh, here's a water bottle. Would you like a water bottle? Like this. Okay. For this one, I asked, would you like orange? Is it some, a, or an? The answer here is an. Why is it an? It's because orange starts with an O. O, which is a vowel. A, E, I, O, U. So we use an here. But another tip, if it's sliced orange, we say some orange, because even though if I hand you 3 slices of oranges, I can count that. It's more than one piece. So I would say, hey, have some orange. Would you like some orange? Like that. Next one, would you like kimchi? Is it some, a, or an? This one is some kimchi. because I can't really count how much kimchi I'm giving you. So I say some kimchi. Like that. Some kimchi. Okay, last one. Would you like some, a, or an hug? What do you think? The answer is a hug. So a hug is one thing. So would you like a hug like this? Maybe if you see your friend is sad, you could say, oh, would you like a hug? Make them feel better. Okay. All right, our second dialogue today. We are learning how to ask for clarification. I know that's a big word, and I will explain what it means. Basically, 해명. Hopefully that translates correctly. Okay, so my first example, this isn't the dialogue. This is just a sentence that will have the dialogue later. Oh, I'll definitely get an earful from mom about coming home late. Now, I said all of this, but you're probably thinking, earful, what does that mean? So if you don't know what it means, you could ask me, what do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? You try. Okay. So basically, if you heard what someone said, but you're thinking, huh? What do they mean? If you don't understand, this is a good phrase to use. And we're going to practice with it right now. Example, so my sister is a social butterfly. Huh? A social butterfly? Remove this. What do you mean? I mean, she loves being around people. So you could ask, can you practice trying letter B? Say letter B. Okay, let's move on. Number two. Wow, you're a sharp kid. You're a sharp kid. What do you think this means? I'll give you a hint. It's the opposite of dull. So you could ask, oh, what do you mean? Is that an insult? But I would say, I mean you're smart. So it's a compliment. If someone calls you sharp, it's a good thing. Okay, last one. Today, I will just be a couch potato. This is probably you guys all throughout this coronavirus. Today, I will just be a couch potato. You could ask, letter B, you try. And then I would say, I mean, I'm going to be lazy. I'm going to sit around all day and do nothing. Sounds like the life. Okay, that was all of our dialogue for today. Really quick, I want to talk about Parents' Day. I think Parents' Day is interesting because we don't have Parents' Day in the US. Instead, we have Mother's Day and Father's Day. So our mother gets her own day, our father gets his own day. And Mother's Day was May 10th, so it already happened. Father's Day is in June, equal. I don't remember which day it is, but I will by the time it gets here. And I will call my father and say, hey, happy Father's Day. Unfortunately, we don't have a Children's Day. I don't know why. When I got to Korea and found out there's a Children's Day, I was like, why don't we have a Children's Day? Where's our celebration of children? Okay, now that I've talked about Parents' Day, it's slang time. Yay! So our first slang word of this week is dope. Dope. Dope has two meanings. They're slang in both meanings, but the old meaning, the one that we don't use anymore, is an idiot. Pavo. Dope means you're a fool. But we don't use this one, so don't worry about number one. The second meaning, the one we will use during class, is cool. So I think it's kind of weird. They mean the opposite of each other, but that's how we use dope now. It means cool or wow, awesome, like that. This is the meaning we will use during class. Don't use number one. Okay. So if I wanted to use a normal word that most English speakers use, I would say, hey, check out this awesome song I just found. Or if you want to use slang around your friends or younger English speakers, you could say, hey, check out this dope song I just found. I say this word often in my everyday English. Okay, another example, normal way to say, wow, those shoes are cool. Thanks. So everybody knows the word cool. It means also like awesome. If you want to add some slang in there, you could say, wow, those shoes are dope. Thanks. Like this. Okay, that was dope for you. Our new word also is sus. Sus. It's really easy. Sus is just a short way to say suspicious or susanjok. So this is the normal way I would just say suspicious. What she said earlier was kind of suspicious, don't you think? Like this. But if you wanted to add some slang, this is the one you should use in the survey. What she said earlier was kind of sus, don't you think? So all I did was take out the suspicious and leave sus, like this. Another example. Oh, this box looks kind of suspicious. Or slang, this one. This box looks kind of sus. Okay, here is your assignment for this week. I made a worksheet. For part one, all you have to do is choose a, an, or some in the blank. And for part two, all you have to do is ask what the person means in the B part. And then after, you can practice the expressions so that you can learn some English expressions and hopefully recognize them in music or movies. Okay. The last part of our lesson is our song of the day. And our song is What Do You Mean by Justin Bieber. I'm sure you've all heard this before, but I'll play it for you. Basically, you're just going to listen to him say, what do you mean? And here we go.
What do you mean?
All right, if you want later, you can listen to that song and practicing What Do You Mean with Justin Bieber. And that was actually all for my lesson today. I hope you enjoyed. Please leave a comment or also fill out the survey, do your homework, and I will see you. No. Yes, I will see you next week on Zoom. Bye. Have an awesome week.